Greetings, this is Brad from the Cheese Shop. In this video, I'm going to be talking about creating a GURPS character. I've decided to break this particular video up into three different sections. I'm going to talk about the point-based system that GURPS uses, character concept, and the basic attributes that a character will have. GURPS uses a point-based system for its character creation. Essentially, what that means is that anything that is a positive to your character is worth points. Anything that is a negative to your character is points taken away. And when you add those, all those points up after you've created your character, that is what your total point character comes out to be. So to give you an example, if we were creating a hero for a fantasy campaign, and I selected a bunch of different skills, I had some advantages and some disadvantages, raised my strength, lowered my IQ, at the very end of all of that, my character would be worth a specific amount of points. And let's say at the very beginning of the adventure, the GM set specific standards for your character. And what I mean by that is the GM would say, you can make a fantasy character, and that character can have up to 150 points. Now, the GM may also set limits on what you can and cannot buy within for that character. Because GURPS is a generic system, there could be a whole slew of choices that a player would have whenever they create a character. So in the beginning, the GM will limit what a character can and cannot have. Now, some of the more notable limits that a GM would give would be the limits on disadvantages. And I'll explain why here in just a second. But usually limits for disadvantages, you know, in my experience, have been anywhere from minus 40 points to minus 60 points for a campaign that starts out with a 150-point character. Now, why they would want to set those limits is it creates a balance to the game. You don't want to necessarily try to make a character that is completely out of whack in one direction and the other, and there's nothing to play in the middle. So in GURPS, because of this using the point-based system, it's easy to balance a character in GURPS because there are so many different choices for creating a character. You can see how this balance is definitely needed. And this is all based on a GM's decision on what can be created with a character. So whenever you're creating a character, it's best to talk to the GM and make sure that those points are laid out at the very beginning. Like, how many points do I get? What are my limitations? What skills can I not have? What advantages or disadvantages I cannot have? And your GM should gladly provide that for you. Now, the second thing that I want to talk about is a character concept. In GURPS, there are no classes like there are in Dungeons & Dragons or Pathfinder or some other tabletop RPGs. Your character concept is essentially anything that you want it to be. You are not limited by what you can come up with other than your imagination. You would want to come up with some sort of backstory in your character concept. It's always a good idea to start with something like that so you get a good idea of exactly where you need to be spending your points. Now, for some of you newer players that are new to tabletop role-playing games, where maybe creating a backstory is difficult or you're just not really used to that, sometimes if you ask your GM, or even you can browse the web, there's a bunch of different checklists and questions that you can ask yourself as a player that you can answer. And some of those things are just basic, you know, am I going to be a male or a female? Do I, you know, what did my parents do for a living? You can start going through different things, and there's a slew of questions you can ask yourself as a player, and how would that character actually answer that? And once you start getting those answers, you'll definitely start coming up with a backstory. And essentially that backstory, once you have that, and you kind of are narrowing down your concept, you're going to know what type of player you're going to be playing. And like I said, with the classes, there are no classes in GURPS, so you're not hindered by, a weapon choice, you know, because you're a magic user, you can't use a specific weapon, or because you're a specific alignment, you can't use these types of spells. In GURPS, it's an unlimited at what you can actually do. But just remember to always run your character story by your GM, because this will actually help him or her prepare the adventure to suit your needs as well. So you're not left out as far as the continuing story will go during the adventure. So it's always a good idea to actually let your GM know exactly what kind of character concept you're coming up with, and both of you work on it together to get maximum fun out of actually playing the game. The third thing that I want to talk about are the basic attributes that GURPS uses. There are four basic attributes: strength, health, dexterity, and IQ. These four attributes have no hidden meaning to them. They mean exactly as they sound. The attributes affect some specific things within the mechanics of the system, and I'm just going to prattle them off really quick right now. They affect damage, basic lift, hit points, will, perception, fatigue points, basic speed, and basic move. All those things, there's different formulas for each one of them. I'm not going to go into each one of those specifically, because I'm assuming you're going to have the book or you're going to be using GURPS Lite or have access to the internet, obviously, because you're watching the video. So what I want to do is just show that those attributes do have effect on those things, and it also determines where you begin with your skill levels. Whether you have the skill or you're trying to use a skill that you don't actually have, the default to that skill is going to be based on your attributes. So now, like I said, with those four attributes, there is a difference. Now, with strength and health, the difference comes with how much it's worth as a point value. Your strength and health is plus or minus 10 points per level. Dexterity and IQ are plus or minus 20 points per level. And I'll talk about the reasons for the difference here in a second. Now, every character in the beginning, normal for a player character is 10. 10 strength is normal, 10 IQ is normal. If you want to make a player that's stronger than normal, say you're going to make a weightlifter type sort of character, he's going to have a higher strength level. And the higher the level is, the more it's going to cost 10 points. So a person that has a strength of 12, it's going to cost them 20 points to have a strength of 12. And he's going to be that much stronger than a person that has a normal strength of 10. And it's the same in the other direction as well. Maybe I am making a character that is smart but is not very healthy and has had, you know, health problems throughout his life. And I want to make a character that has a health of minus, you know, of 8. So he's not quite as healthy as a normal person. So that'd be minus 20 points. And that all comes into the total of the total points that were allowed at the beginning from your GM. Dexterity and IQ being the 20 points per level, the reason why that there's a difference is that those, if you've played any type of RPGs, you realize that there's some uber stats. Stats that can create imbalance within a game. And dexterity and IQ are surely one of those. Because almost all of your skills and every type of check that you do is going to be based on dexterity and IQ. So you can see how if everything was at level, you know, at 10 points per level, you could really start unbalancing the game. So the GURPS made a conscious effort to actually make changes from previous editions and make dexterity and IQ worth 20 points per level. So that is the reason for having those differences, and it's essentially all about the game balance. So this is the end of this video. I want to just reiterate some of the things that we've talked about. The first thing is the point-based system that GURPS uses, character concept, and the basic attributes. This is something that's actually going to get you going in the character creation process. A lot of players actually start with this at the beginning. Some actually start at different areas in the character creation process. But if you're new to GURPS or new to tabletop role-playing, this is always a good way to start. I can't reiterate enough. It's always, you always, always, always have to talk to the GM about your character. Because of the complexity that GURPS can entail, and the amount of points that are being used, you could spend a few hours making a character and then say to the GM, hey, this is my character. And then the GM goes, well, that's not really what we're looking for. It's going to affect party dynamics, or, you know, there may be some limitations that you hadn't taken into consideration. And then you're going to have to go back and actually make another character or make some major changes within a character. So always, always, always talk with your GM when you're creating a character. Now I'm going to, like you said, talk about some more parts of the process later in different videos, and I hope you enjoyed this one. As always, down at the bottom, comment. I do welcome comments. And if you haven't already, visit my blog at thecheeseshop.org. Thank you. Bye.